Good afternoon, everybody. Good morning. Wherever we are. Enjoying yourself so far? Having a nice day?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, good.
I'm not going to take up too much of your time. I'll take over from Si to guide for the short time that you're going to be here. Find it enjoyable. We're going to show you how the carpets are made. We've got a lady doing a demonstration for you for spinning the wall with a drop spindle. I'll explain a little bit about that in just a moment. And these natural materials behind me that are used to dye wool, although we don't dye any wool on the premises, it's just really to give you an idea what can be used to get some different colours. We'll go across to one of the looms and I'll show you one of the trainee girls weaving the carpet and explain about the knotting techniques that are used in the different materials and the reasons why. We'll extract a little bit of silk from silk cocoons. I don't know if you've seen that before. Quite interesting to see.
There's three parts to a handmade carpet. They're called warps, weft and pile. The warps are vertical threads that you saw the lady spinning in the last section. The weft, if you've ever seen a mechanical loom with the shuttles going backwards and forwards, the weft's a little bit like the shuttle sort of principle. It goes in between the two rows of vertical threads. These are used to separate the front and the back to make it easier to thread it through. It's woven through the four on each end of the carpet that gives you the seam on the edge to keep everything in. And after every line of knots is put in, the knot that she's tying there is professionally known as a Gordes knot. Anybody can do it with a couple of minutes of practice. Two vertical threads. She takes the back vertical thread forward, they're in couples, front and back. The wool goes in between the two, across the front, behind the back vertical thread, and underneath. Some of you might have Persian, Indian or Chinese carpets, same principle, they're two vertical threads. Their weaver's coming from the outside and loop the back vertical thread. This is known as a single knotting technique. It doesn't mean that Turkish carpets are better, double knots, single knots. In fact, it doesn't really do anything to the durability of the carpet. The main advantage with a double knotted carpet is really just cleaning it. Just in Bursa, a town underneath Istanbul. Why they produce there? They grow a lot of mulberry trees in the region and the silkworms feed on the leaves from the mulberry trees. As it dabs the cocoons in the water, it will catch, find and pick up the ends of the fibres. Just mind this, it might be a bit hot up there, it's not too bad. Catch the end there. And now take a couple of metres off to get it started. You'll loop it through one of the hooks, round the bobbin on the top, connect it to the spinning wheel. As he spins the wheel, it'll extract the silk from the cocoon. Okay. Invented by the Chinese, it was a well-kept secret for hundreds of years as they used to trade in the silk. Let me see if we can connect it now. You can feel the silk if you want to. The water's not, because it's going so bad. You can see how strong it is. It doesn't matter if you break some off. Can you see those? I'm going to play. Join them back on if you like. Sit back, relax, and have a drink. You do not have to buy any carpets here. You do have to drink some.